The funny man will have you in aches, but she can also leave you speechless. Katherine Ryan talks to Eva Wiseman about bone implants and restroom training and the jokes indeed she would NT risk moment. Eva Wiseman. Sun November 7, 202108.00 GMT. Katherine Ryan has named her autobiography The Audacity, a word, she explains, most generally used to indicate disapprobation. Like, how dare she carry herself with that wicked cornucopia of tone belief? How audacious! It's the perfect title. The absolute perfect title for a bio by a funny man equal corridor shoddy and lurid, notorious for her exacting station, persuading invulnerability and torn down to tone deprecate. Her cover print, shot when she was 9 months pregnant, sees Ryan lucent and golden in an ice blue gown trimmed with marabou feathers, holding above in her left hand her fave of her three bitsy tykes. It's these small tykes that hail me at her frontal door, and an entirely other lady. Rather of television's Katherine Ryan be lashed and glowing, a happy cross between Christine Baranski and Taylor Swift, I am a by real life Ryan makeup lesson leggings, incontinently offering me a plate of halloumi salad and a selection of milks for my tea. A bone pump sits on the counter beside a bag of golden hair extensions and outdoors, by the dainty heated swimming pool, her 12-week-old baby Fred sleeps gently in his perambulator. The atmosphere is one of Californian tranquility in the London cities, only punctured slightly by her description of a man lowering his anus onto a bed post. I had asked what people suppose of her and she had answered like this: there are men who suppose I am a dominatrix. And they ask me for a bank account so that they can shoot me plutocrat, or ask me to step on their balls, or to draw them in some way. One man transferred a picture of himself lowering himself onto the post of his bed, saying, "Please retweet this to cheapen me." She gets a lot of that, because they view me as nascence. The reason why people say women are NT funny is because it's nascence to be the only person in the room allowed to speak. And I suppose we VE only lately accepted that women can be nascence, too. Which is where the misreading comes from, why people suppose only men are funny. She pauses to check on the baby. And that's why some men suppose that I want to stand on their balls. But we're getting ahead of ourselves, because this interpretation of Ryan, the bone who hosts panel shows and receives evisceration requests, was shaped by careful accident over 38 times, beginning in Sarnia, a small petrochemical city in Canada. She was restless and popular, and at 19 worked as a waitress with a friend called Jessica. In her book, Ryan calls this chapter "How to Let Your Friend's Murder Define All Your Connections." One day Jessica did NT turn up to work and soon Ryan heard she'd been killed by her ex-boyfriend. "That's how it happens," Ryan's mum told her that evening. However, they occasionally kill you, if you leave them. "I felt shamefaced jotting about that," she says, "because when you write your own book, you really center yourself." She was NT my stylish friend, she was NT my family, but it affected me, and it affected all the youthful women in our city, too. It was an assignment. When your brain is still growing, the events of your life write on the oil of who you are. Without indeed knowing it, I learned, if you piss them off, they lol kill you. Times latterly she'd joke on stage, effects like, "Men are nature's gun. You re statistically most likely to be killed by the one in your house." Haha. And until lately I did NT indeed realize myself, how spooked I was. A man tiptoes into the room, and busts the baby down. Not only is her hubby Bobby one of the first good men Ryan has dated in the history she had a habit of going out with, the kinds of gallant Silas Tykes bark at, in burlesque shows she'd laugh that her pater would meet them and suppose, "Did I molest her and forget?" But he was the factual first man, too, her high academy swain. They were reunited in 2018 when she visited Canada to retake BBC show Who Do You Suppose You Are, and married a time latterly. They hadn't seen each other since she moved to Toronto for university, where she took a job at Hooters, a sports bar known for its waitresses' meager uniforms, and started to have the time of her life. I know in retrospection it's perhaps not the most aspirational thing that you can do, because it's situating yourself as being for decoration, which isn't ideal, but I was always a pupil of what I was doing. I allowed it was fascinating to hold that position as a youthful woman. She performed in their bikini pageant and visited the Playboy manse. I wanted to exploit that reverence given to delicate innocent youth. She also wanted bigger tits and started to probe plastic surgery. It was such a specific time in pop culture, wasn't it? With an intriguing kind of feminism. When I was in high academy, I clearly knew about plastic surgery and I valued being beautiful. I allowed plastic surgery was an aspirational, veritably Hollywood thing that rich people could do. While numerous jesters asked about early icons might name check maybe Monty Python or Richard Pryor, Ryan was an addict of celebrities like Jessica Simpson and Britney Spears. I allowed it was so amazing that they could change the way they looked with wisdom. I had a roster of surgeries, all part of my plan for getting a nice girl who's enough and scourged. I wanted to alter effects, not for any deep dark body dysmorphia. Just, curiosity. I wanted to be woman-like, and I wanted to be liked. So I got bone implants. And they were great.